ever thought that I would ever have breast cancer. Never even crossed my mind.
You gotta phone your wife and tell her she has breast cancer.
I thought, oh, it can't happen to me. I'm too young. I haven't even seen my kid go into kindergarten yet.
July 11th, 2005, our lives changed forever. I mean, my wife was diagnosed with breast cancer.
Every year I listen to the radio marathon and I honestly sit and cry listening to the stories and I go, oh my gosh, those poor women.
Yeah.
And then I, all of a sudden, here I am.
The look on her face. I knew that it was not good news. Something a mother never wants to ever hear, that her child has breast cancer.
Being such a young woman and having two small kids at home, I was shocked.
Your life's running along smoothly and then you're told you have cancer.
At a really young age.
With her being so young getting it, I'm 17, thinking about getting my breast checked for that.
Mm.
That's a scary thought.
You need to know, is that mine? Keeps thinking you had enough, but the heart keeps telling you don't give up. Who are we to be questioning, wondering what is what? Don't give up. Through it all, just stand up.
I told him I wasn't going to the wedding if I didn't have any hair. And he said, that's no problem. He said, here's the money. And me and his girlfriend, wife-to-be, we went out and we bought a wig. And I prayed to God that day that I wouldn't be sick so I could attend and be there for the whole day. And I wasn't sick.
What's the most frustrating part of being the mother in this situation?
Wishing that I could be there instead of her.
She's shown such a brave face. I've never seen her ever complain or ever feel sorry for herself.
Comes with those research donations.
My mom drives from Elrose up to North Battleford and takes me into Saskatoon for treatments. My family and my friends have been amazing.
I feel more loved than I ever have in my entire life.
What do you want to say to your friends and family? Like you?
I just want to thank them for all the support that they gave me, and I couldn't have done it without them. I knew that I was going to beat this.
Yeah, you definitely look at life in a different way. The small things don't matter anymore. I felt loved. I felt that people wanted to help me.
Don't give up. Through it all,
my immediate thoughts were that my daughter has to pull every ounce of strength out of her body to fight this. And she's now cancer-free, so we're so happy.
My husband, Murray Harper, I hope you're listening, honey. I love you. I can't do this without you. Thank you.
Potash Corp for $25,000.
Christina's been growing her hair since she was born. She's donating 18 inches of hair.
I want to mention Marietz Reese and the Red Bras Rocks ladies. $18,000. The Lisa Rendell Golf Classic, Lisa's personal fundraising event, and that was over $63,000.
We can't thank Lisa Rendell enough. We love you, Lisa. We're so proud of you, and we're there for you, whatever you need.
The total for the 11th annual C95 Radio Marathon for Breast Cancer Research is $342,250. Woo!